Take a look at this brilliant AI tool from Google. I was able to upload all these different types of files from PDFs, Google Docs, Google Slides, my own notes, and web links, and then with one click, turn into a podcast with two people talking. Take a quick listen here.
How is this AI tool shaking things up in education? And more specifically, what's it like from a student's perspective?
It's definitely a hot topic.
To get to the bottom of this, we're diving into some fascinating research. We've got two papers and a whole journal article.
Isn't that amazing? Well, today I'm going to show you how to do this in NotebookLM, but I want to show you all the great things that you can do to really give yourself an advantage and quite the study hack. Let me tell you the best things about NotebookLM. First of all, it's completely free. You just need a Google account to access it. It's running Gemini Pro 1.5, and any of the information that you upload to it is going to stay private. They're not going to scrape it to train any of their models. So once you have your Gmail account, just go ahead and click on Try Me, and it's going to bring you right in. You can see it has an easy user face, and they have some examples that you can go ahead and test out at the beginning. But I'm going to start by just uploading some of the information that I showed you I had at the very beginning in the intro. If you prefer to work in light mode, just go up to the settings and you can make that quick switch back and forth. And you'll also notice that we have some notebook FAQ and a Discord you could join there. Let's go ahead now and go and create a new notebook. So when we go ahead and click on it, you'll see this is where we add our sources to. So we can upload our sources. So I can choose the file and go from this way and grab documents. So I can grab a PDF, and you'll see now for my sources, I just have the one, but you can still add more. But even at this one, I can do things like create the podcast based on this one right here. I could go ahead and click generate, but I'm going to come back to this. I want to upload a few more documents. So I'm going to go ahead and click the plus here, and we'll go ahead and just drag another one in here. And you can see now we have multiple ones, because as I drag up this information, these documents that I've already curated, now I'm going to be able to have a discussion with this NotebookLM, and they'll be able to find connections between them based on what I'm telling it to look for. So let's go ahead. I'm going to go and add a few more. This time I have a web link over here, just of an AI documents. I'm going to go back and just go to the website. I can paste a URL right into here to get my third one. I can also go into things like Google Docs or Google Slides. So if I click on Google Docs, I should have a Google Docs right in here that I can insert. And we'll go ahead and put in some Google Slides also. So you can see all the different sources that I've put in. Now we can cross-reference them and try to see what connections that are between them. So we've added some PDFs, Google Slides, Google Docs, and we just came back from a class and we want to quickly add those notes from the prof. If I go back up to add source, I can paste in the text here. So I go copy text, I can paste in the information and hit insert. And then you can see right away we have this as part of what AI will reference. I don't want to have this called pasted text, so I'm just going to go and rename the source. You can also remove the source. So if I just go rename, I'm going to go and call this just notes from class. Just because to keep things simple. So I have this now called Notes from Class. The other thing I want to name is just going up here, and I'm just going to call this AI Info, just so that everything's not called untitled when I create a new notebook. So we have these six different sources. If I look down below, I have the six different sources here. So since they're all checked, I could start asking questions over here, just like normal AI. But what I want to show you first, if I click on any of them, so let's click on this PDF, I can see the summary right here of that document. And I really like how they have these key topics that will be generated for each of these articles. If I scroll down below, you can see the content. But if I go and click on, let's say, student engagement here, it's going to go ahead and find that student engagement in this source here and place it here. And everything's going to be cited as well. So here we go. If we take a look at this, I'll scroll up a little bit, student engagement. Whenever you see this, this is going to be cited. So it'll show me where that they're pulling this from. So the information I give it, and then I can double check what they're writing to make sure that this is real. This isn't a hallucination that sometimes AI can do. If I click on it, it will bring me to that spot in the document. I love that feature. So this becomes part of the chat with AI. I'm just gonna close here. And right now I'm in the chat. So if I go down, I can continue asking questions. They're even prompting me here. So if I go, how do AI tools impact student engagement in higher education, then AI will double check this for that specific question based on all the different check marks that I have. Now, when you come across any of these that you like, you can save it as a note. You can also copy the text from here, but if you want to save it as a note, just click here and it becomes part of the notes, and you can use it as you click on it. This could be, you can see how you can add note, delete notes from here. So I'm just going to click off of it right now. The chat is always going to be, if you want it open or closed, just click view chat, and you can see the conversation here as I've asked different questions from the documents as I go through, and still you can check the citing. So you can close the chat over here. Again, if I want to see the notebook guide, I can click over here, and it's going to have suggested questions of these, and it's going to be based on those six sources. What I really like are these features. So it's helped me create an FAQ, a study guide, table of contents, timeline, briefing doc. So let's do a little example here. So maybe I just uncheck a few of these here. I'll just use these two PDFs. Can it make me a study guide? So if I go ahead and click this, this is going to be generate me a study guide. And in the study guide, it's going to give me questions and answers and essay possibilities based on these two articles. Here's the study guide. You can see we have our question and answers here. Here are the questions. If I scroll down, the answer key is right here. And if I keep scrolling down, essay questions. And remember, this is based on those two articles there. So if I just click off of it, you'll see that we have our study guide as part of our notes here. If I go back to notebook guide, I'm not going to run through them all, but whatever ones I click, I can do any of these quick capabilities here by just clicking on them and having what I want to have selected. Now, do remember, we can use this just like a normal ChatGPT or Gemini. If I go ahead and if it's based on these two here, I can go and ask it to give me ideas for a possible introduction paragraph. It will even write things for you. So if I go ahead and just ask it for the ideas, it will generate ideas based on those two articles. And again, after it's done writing, you can see how everything is sourced where it's going to be pulling from. So it can give you some great creativity to get those ideas and connections between all these different ones. Again, I'm just going to go and close out of this. I'm going to go back to the notebook guide, because what I started was creating the podcast, and it's so easy to do. So if I go again and select all the sources here, all I have to do is click on generate, and it just takes a couple minutes. I won't make you watch the whole thing, but then we're going to have this podcast and we can even download it. Here we go. It's all ready. I'm going to go ahead and hit play.
Listener name. Ready to jump into this AI and education research? I am. Let's go. We're focusing on student engagement, right?
Yeah, definitely. And how it's like actually...
Isn't that great? How real that sounds and how quick that gets created. So now what you could do with this is, if we click on the ellipses, we can go ahead and download this as an MP3. So you could take it with you, and if you're on a drive, or you can put it on any device to listen to, and you're studying as you listen to this podcast. You can also delete it and change the playback speed here as well. I want to point out, there is share up top. Whenever you're inside one of your notebooks, you can share this out. Just remember, if you put any personal information that you don't want other people to know, make sure you don't share it with other people. So I hope you like this walkthrough, a tutorial of how to use NotebookLM. This is one of my favorite AI tools here. I just love how quickly you can go through research and make connections between different articles based on the information that you curated. Let me know what you think about this and how much and how you are using it. Thanks for watching. This time on Teachers Tech, I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.